Hi there. I've got a quick video today just showing you how to do a screenshot without using any external APIs. I've been wondering how to do this for a while and I've found a little hack that uses some Symfony code, which Laravel is based on. I'm not sure if you've heard of Symfony before, but that's another framework and Laravel uses that in the back end. So I've found some Symfony functions that you can use to run commands on the shell. So I've, instead of going through how to do it all, I've just mocked up a demo and I'm going to talk you through how it works, which I think will be quicker so you don't have to sit there and watch me type everything out. So basically I've just got a view here with a box to put in a URL of a website and then a button just to submit it. So I'll just show you the code. So I've just made a screenshot controller. I've got a function, a method called showForm, which just shows that view that I've just shown you. And then this is the code that actually processes it. So I've literally just got two routes. Sorry, one to display on the GET, and one to handle the request when we submit the form. And that's literally just the view. So I'll just close that down for now. So basically all this does is it receives the request from the form. I've named my input URL. So we just set URL as whatever we typed in that box. Obviously you can do more validation on this to make it a valid URL and all that stuff, but I thought there's no point putting stuff like that in because you probably know how to do that anyway. So what I've done with the name, this is for the file name, so I thought it might cause some problems if you put in dots and slashes and things like that in the name. So what I've done is used Laravel's slugify helper, which is, if you just go to the helpers section, it just converts any string into, it changes like characters that might break things into dashes and things like that. So that should give us a safe file name. And then this is the little hack that I discovered. I'm using Laravel Homestead to do my work locally, but as long as you can get on to your server and SSH in, all you need to do is install a Chromium browser, which comes with Homestead, so you don't even have to do anything if you're using Homestead. This will just work straight away. So what it does is this process actually lets you run a command as if you were SSHing into the server. So this is, if you SSH into the server and ran this command with the URL on the end, it would generate a screenshot for you. So when it gets to this, it opens up a Chrome browser without, it's called headless, so you're not actually seeing it, it just does it in the background. So you can set the size of the window that you want. I've done disabled JavaScript just because sometimes you go to a website and you see those pop-ups for the cookies and things like that. And I didn't really want it to show on the screenshots. So that seems to have stopped most of those coming up, because I think most of them are JavaScript powered. So this is just a timeout. So I think that's seconds. I think it's seconds. Set working directory. So I've set that as my public folder in the storage, so that is here. So what it does is every time you run this, it overwrites this screenshot.png with the new screenshot to get it on the server, and then literally this part is just in case anything goes wrong. So if anything fails, you'll get an exception with why it's failed. From here on downwards, it's just processing the image. So I'm not sure if you've heard of intervention image. It's my go-to image manipulation library. So I'll just show you. So this is the website. I'll put the link in the description below. But you literally just do composer require intervention / image. And then there's a few tutorials if you want to have a look how to get started with it, but it's really simple to use. So all you have to do is put, once you've installed it all, there's a few things that you have to do for installation, but once it's all installed, all you have to do is put the use image at the top. And then you can do things like this just makes the image into the variable. So what we're doing is getting that screenshot that we created just now and saving it in the image variable so that we can manipulate it with that library. So the first thing that I'm doing is cropping a tiny bit off the right hand side, because if you go to a website, you've got a scroll bar usually. So that should get rid of the scroll bar because it's getting a screenshot from the full Chrome browser, you end up with a little bit of a scroll bar at the side. So that just gets rid of that. If you notice, I've set the width as that, and then my actual window is just a tiny bit bigger, so that just gets rid of the screen, the scroll bar. And then this is my large image. I'm doing a large image and a thumbnail with this. So once we've cropped that scroll bar off, we save that image into storage. This is just a standard Laravel storage command, which sets the path of it, which I've put here as / screenshots and then the name .jpg, and then it encodes it as a JPEG with a little bit of quality taken off just to optimize it, because where I was using this code before, I wanted the images to load really fast. And then public just means that it doesn't matter too much locally, but if you're using like S3 or anything like that, you want it to be public so that people can actually load it from the S3 bucket. And then once we've saved that version, I resize it down to 200 pixels wide. And then this function here just sizes it down but keeps the aspect ratio the same, so you don't get any squashing or anything like that. So this is our thumbnail. And then we've got a separate path for the thumbnail here, which it's going to use to save that in a separate location. So let's try it and see if it actually works. I'm just going to try it on my channel to start with. Hopefully it should work. So we've got that message at the end of the controller. This isn't how I would actually usually do it, by the way. I'd put it in a service or something like that. I just thought, for the sake of demoing it in a simple way, this is an easy way to just show you the whole code in one place. So if we look in screenshots, we've got our two versions of the image. So it's saved that. And then a thumbnail version as well. So let's just try it. Let's just try this one, just to make sure that it was working. Let's see if it's there. So that's the thumbnail. And then this is the screenshot. You can see the quality is not amazing, but you can higher that number up. So if you wanted it to be a bigger file but better quality, you could just increase this number here and you'd get a better resolution image. Hopefully that helps someone who's trying to do that. There are a lot of paid services that people use just to do this function. So I thought if it can save people money and time, then I'm happy to make a video. If you've got any suggestions for other videos that you want me to do, just drop me a comment and I'll try and do a video on it. Thanks for watching. Make sure you're subscribed if you're not subscribed. I'll see you in the next video.